According to Daniel J. Towsey, www.twitter.com/danieltowsey, my employment required that I do everything that I was instructed and that I never reveal my employer's activities to anyone at any time. My employer would not allow me to have a conscience as to whether it was morally right to do it or not. My employer's reasoning was always concerned about how can they achieve their ends and never whether it was right to do it or not. My employer behaved exactly like a crime syndicate whose only interest was for their own profit and not for the good of others. My employer's public appearance of goodness and righteousness had to be maintained at all costs. My employer's true evil activities were never to be revealed. I was a receptionist. I was always the first impression that the public received of my employer. I had to maintain the most happy and pleasant face at all times. The longer I did my job, the more I began to know about my employer. Day after day I was confronted by people that were harmed by my employer. The people would always describe their grievances, therefore I began to really understand the evil of my employer. But I had to continue being a happy, cheerful greeter. Over time I realized just how evil and insane my employer really was. I realized the true harm that my employer was doing to humanity. But the image of my employer that was presented in corporate media was always one of a very honest and moral employer. All this evil and deception began to make me sick. I could no longer sleep well, I could no longer eat heartily. I could no longer relate with my friends, family and people. But I continued to go to work and smile and be very pleasant for my employer. Until one day another person's grievance was just too much for me. I got so sick and threw up all over my employer's expensive marble floor. I was so deathly ill from the constant exposure to the absolute evil of my employer. My moral conscience was in complete conflict with my employer's lack of moral conscience. I was further weakened by the idea that I needed my job to pay for my existence of indentured servitude to the bankers. I knew I could never quit until one day, I called in sick. I was now on sick leave. My employer required that I go to a doctor and have the doctor inform my employer as to my prognosis. But I was too weak to get to my doctor's office. So one day came that my employer called me at home and was concerned that I was costing my employer money while I was off sick. My employer said that they could not continue giving me sick pay if I did not have a prognosis. Well, I gave my employer my prognosis. I told my employer what made me sick. I described my experiences as a receptionist. I, having a good moral conscience to always being truthful, told my employer that, "You make me sick." My employer immediately fired me. That was fine with me for while I was off sick and still employed. I went out and found another job. I realized that that was the only cure to my sickness. Now I am understanding why our society has become so sick. In my previous employment I learned never ever again to trust any corporate media image of anything. I no longer read or watch anything the corporate media puts out. I now live a wonderful and simple life. I have now become psychologically cleansed. And every day brings new simple pleasures. I feel healthy now. Everywhere I go people wonder why I am always smiling and so extremely happy. It's because I no longer do the evil deeds of my employer. I wish everyone else in our society could be happy too. My smiles will never end. I could